So what do you do if you did live there? Let's say you lived there with your parents from, if you were my age and you were born in 1953, and you moved there when you were six, and you lived near the plant, or maybe within a mile of the plant, and you saw this kind of sooty stuff that would, come out of the plant occasionally and get on your laundry, hung out to dry, and your parents would say, yeah, that stuff came from Durez, but nobody, it's just a nuisance. We don't know, have no reason to believe it's harmful. Now it's years later. So now you know. And what do? Well, you really can't test. As far as I know, there's no medical technology that would allow you to prognosticate or predict or find very, 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 very early signs of the development at a cellular level of mesothelioma. So you can do some screening. You can have an annual or every other year or every 3 years CT scan, for example, to see whether there's any fluid accumulating in the pleural cavity that is in that space between the lining of the lung and the chest wall. That's an indication. A pleural effusion is an indication of some pathology in the lung, or if it occurs in your abdomen, some pathology there, and mesothelioma affects both the pleural lining of the lung and the peritoneal lining of the abdomen. But it's only through a screening like that you might detect it at an early stage. There have been advances in surgical techniques and in medical techniques. People getting mesothelioma, I think now over the past 5, 10, 15 years, are beginning to live longer, but to alter or deter the course of the disease, even though you've found it at a very early stage, doesn't really keep you from getting mesothelioma or experiencing its profound effects, which when it's completely at its final stages, basically forms a hard, stiff rock-like surface on the lung, crushing the lung, or in the case of the abdomen, crushing abdominal organs, and in both instances causing extreme nerve pain and eventual death. If you or someone you love grew up around the plant, at the first indication of an unusual onset of shortness of breath, or a heaviness in the chest, or an accumulation of fluid in the abdomen or the chest, which is pressing on your organs, and in the case of your chest, on your lungs, making it harder to breathe, and all of a sudden you're having trouble getting those groceries out of the car and bringing them up the steps to the house, you should absolutely consult a doctor. And you should tell that doctor, I'm concerned, I grew up in the Durez neighborhood. Please, go to the doctor first. If there's an indication that you've got an asbestos pathology like mesothelioma, please consider contacting us after you've seen the doctor, after you've sought medical care, and after there's some indication that you may be suffering from an asbestos-related disease. Yes, don't delay at that point. Come and see a lawyer. There are time deadlines, and time does fly.